The Central Pacific Hurricane Center released its outlook for the season, which starts in less than 2 weeks. Robert Ballard, Science and Operations Officer at the Central Pacific Hurricane Center, joins us this morning with all the details on the big announcement from yesterday. Good morning, Robert.
Good morning, Kelly.
Okay, so can you tell us what exactly was the announcement? What are we expecting for our 2021 hurricane season?
Yeah, so it looks like here in the Central Pacific Basin, which covers the area from 140 west longitude to the dateline, so it's a pretty big chunk of real estate out there in the ocean, we are expecting anywhere from about 2 to 5 tropical cyclones in the area, and that includes tropical depressions, tropical storms, and hurricanes. That doesn't necessarily mean that all of those are going to affect Hawaii, but that's what we expect as a total number for the basin by the end of the season.
Okay, and the forecast also called for an 80% chance of near or below normal season. So can you tell us exactly what that means? What do we typically see in a normal season?
Right, so a typical season out here in the Central Pacific would see somewhere around 4, maybe 5 tropical cyclones. The total number through the entire season, and that includes the whole area. In this case, there's always a little bit of uncertainty each year. We're not perfect with these outlooks, and so we try to give a little bit of a range so that we're looking at atmospheric conditions, we're looking at ocean conditions, and trying to zero in on what we think is going to happen. So most likely, we think we'll see somewhere a near normal season, and then when you include the greatest possibility, it looks like it's going to be a near normal to somewhat below normal season, depending on whether or not La Nina kicks back in as we head into the fall.
Right. And can you talk a little bit more on that? Because right now we're in an ENSO neutral phase, but can you talk about what exactly that means and what it would mean if we did go back into a La Nina phase and what effect that has on the forecast?
Right. So the ENSO cycle includes what you hear El Nino, which is a warming of the Central Pacific waters along the equator. Then you have La Nina, which is a cooling of the waters along the equator. And then ENSO neutral is in the middle where it's close to average. And so in this case, that's where we're at right now. We're ENSO neutral. And it looks like there's a chance we could go back to La Nina, which is what we had last over the winter season. We could see that again as we head into the fall.
Okay, and that was, again, a factor for the cooler sea surface temperatures. Hopefully that is the case and that we don't have all the extra warm water energy that the hurricanes really get fuel from. So when it comes to last season, it was fairly inactive, as was forecast. But as we saw with Douglas, we got a very close call.
Yeah, so here you had an example of what we're always talking about when we say it only takes one. We only had one hurricane in the Central Pacific last year, but that hurricane made a beeline right for Hawaii. It only missed Oahu by about 30 miles, 25 or 30 miles, and that is the closest approach that we've had to a hurricane in probably 60, 70, maybe more years. So we were really, really lucky last year. Mm-hmm. We know at some point we're not going to be so lucky, so we want folks to be prepared because eventually we're going to get hit. And if you're not ready when we're hit, it's going to be big problems.
Right. I'm not sure if it officially came out yet. Have you heard? I heard that the Eastern Pacific was releasing their forecast this morning. Has that come out yet? Do you know?
Yeah, I believe they have made that announcement. I haven't taken a look at that just yet to go through it. But I believe that was supposed to have been done today. So something to keep an eye on. Of course, that gets sort of factored into our own outlook, what the oceanic conditions are. So I would expect that it would reflect something similar, but we'll have to take a look and see.
Yes, because of course, all of the forecasters, they are looking at the very similar conditions, the ENSO neutral phase, and then potentially a La Nina. So hopefully they also are going to be forecasting that near or below normal season. So what would you like the public to know? When it comes to these numbers, we're hearing 2 to 5 tropical cyclones. Exactly what does that mean and how should we be preparing?
Yeah, I think the one thing to consider is that these numbers do not reflect the number of cyclones that we expect to approach Hawaii. Mm-hmm. We're just not at the state of the science right now to be able to tell you early in the season whether or not Hawaii is going to be threatened. So even during an inactive year like we had last year, we need folks to sort of stay tuned, keep an eye on the weather, pay attention to the weather. Don't wait until we're under some sort of hurricane threat to start getting supplies and materials and preparing. The best time to do that is now, when you're not under a lot of stress from the weather situation, that you have that time to make a plan and start enacting the plan, and get those supplies ready so that when you have, when we actually do get a threat at some point, you'll be ready and you'll have a lot less stress and worry as you're going through and just enacting the plan to get ready for a hurricane.
Definitely. And for those who are looking to be more informed, do you have any resources that we can head to? Where should they be turning to?
Yeah, you can always go to hurricanes.gov. That includes the Central Pacific and the Eastern Pacific, so you can look at all of the hurricane activity in the basin to keep an eye on what's going on. You can also go to ready.gov/Hawaii, and they have a lot of preparedness tips and things that you should be thinking about during the preseason to get ready for hurricane season. We're only, you know, just over 10 days away, so it's coming up quick. Time flies, so always a great time to get ready.
Yes, definitely. And of course, we'll continue to track both the Eastern and Central Pacific and give you the very latest on any potential systems that are headed our way. Again, a good forecast, encouraging, positive to hear that it's a near or below normal season. But as we always say, it just takes just one. And last year we had just one that came way too close for comfort. We got so lucky. And it's so unfortunate that so many people take that for granted and think that Hawaii's protected. We're not. We're just a very small target, and we really could potentially get hit, and eventually we will. So make sure you're going through your hurricane kits. Make sure you have all your food is still current, nothing expired, and make sure everything's up to date and you have a plan with your family. But thank you so much, Robert, for joining us this morning, and you're always such a great resource. I'm sure if we do have any systems, you're probably going to be popping on here a bit more.
Yeah, I hope it's a quiet season, but we should always be ready. So now's the time.
Yes, definitely. All right. Thanks again, Bob, for joining us this morning.
Take care, Kelly.